the neat thing about this bag, besides just the fact that it's got the watercolor technique, on the inside it has a pair of jeans. This is a stencil that I cut myself, and it has, this is the only one that I ever made that didn't have Levi's in it. You could use really any jean that you were comfortable working with. So in terms of what kind of jeans are appropriate, this demi curve, which is a size 11, is so short in the front compared to the back, it gets kind of harder to square up this bucket, and so this wouldn't be my first choice. Plus these are in really nice shape, and so these I might just put in the Goodwill box. These, on the other hand, are not in very good shape, and these are men's 34 waist. This is a little smaller than I usually have tried to use, but it certainly is going to work, and I'll just make my bag fit it. But the size of these pants is really what's going to determine the size of your bag, especially right here at the waist. And without, because we don't leave the actual waistband on, we have a little bit of play with this size where we can squinch it up a little bit and ease it a little smaller, or we can kind of stretch it out when we're attaching. And the quilted extension that we're gonna put on the top of our jeans liner and then sew to the top of our art bag on the outside, that little extension is going to angle down to this. So the bag itself will be a little bit bigger, and this will hang inside of the art bag a little bit smaller, and we'll work on that sizing as we go. These are a 38, and they're quite large, and they have a black denim, but I'm going to go ahead and use them because I have them, and because the problem with these jeans is my husband says they're very uncomfortable. These men's styles, where when you lay it flat like this, it's just exactly what you need, are really good. So when I do this, I like to get these loops off because I don't use the loops. You could do this any way you wanted. I get the waistband and the loops off because I don't want the pockets to be shortened. I want them as long as possible. I take this part off. I suppose you could leave it on there. And if I I go pretty fast. If I accidentally made a hole where I didn't want to, I would patch that. These actually can look pretty cute with some patches inside. I've used some very, very holy jeans, and thought the patches were actually, based on the reaction people have when they look inside the bag, I thought they were actually kind of a feature. You can use any kind of jean. I've used all Levi's except for one, which is one of the ones that I showed in an earlier video. And I like Levi's, well, because my husband wears Levi's and a lot of our friends wear Levi's. And because I find them to be easy to take apart. I think I worked on a pair of Wranglers once, and they were just different, and I just didn't have it down the same way. And so you just get this waistband taken off. And you try to be pretty sensitive to what you're doing so that if you start slicing into the fabric that you want to still be there, you stop. I'm going to try another one that's not, doesn't lose its cap so easily. At some point these teeth are going to become an issue for us, and you could actually cut them off, which is probably what I'm going to do right now. I don't want to take any more of the zipper off than I need to, but I just want to get those off of there so that I don't hit that with my needle later on, because the zipper will shoot right off the end. It'll just go off, and then you just have to take some time to put it back on. But I try to just trap it on there. And we leave this fly active. I did stitch this closed a little there, and just a little bit here. One of the steps that we do, if we haven't done it already, is cut the legs off. And we're going to be using only down to about here, but I still, especially for this first time, think it's best to cut off a little bit, an inch or two below the crotch of the pants, and try to cut sort of straight across. It's nice if you can find a use for those legs, and if you need those legs to be long, once you've made a couple, you could definitely make those shorter. What I'm going to show is how I prepare these to make the bucket for the liner. And all I do to get this going is cut out this inseam, just right along the stitching, cut that out, and then we turn it inside out. You can kind of see that what we want to do is just flatten this out like this, and then sew. I'll pin it, but we want to sew kind of in a continuation of this line here, and so we just want to kind of go across there and down here. And because of this thickness here, this is a good time to find a way to prop your foot. And right now I'm just using a neutral construction color. Now my whole foot is propped up, so right there I'm not going to worry about it. I would use a fairly big stitch for this in case you end up wanting to take it out and change how you've done things. Shaping this jeans bucket is more art than science, because it really, you're trying to make a box out of a shape that was originally cut to fit the human body. And so, and with this back part, it's the same thing. I usually fold it about like this, and I usually go pretty high up between the pockets. And I don't go up past this big knuckle here. Seams joining together. And I'm gonna come down like this. And when I do it like that, pin it. look in there. We can see it does do this kind of pinch here, and that's having it flat with this flat edge of the seam with this part of the seam on the edge, on the folded edge. So here's the actual joining of the fabric right there, and I'm folded on that, and if I stitch like that, I'll have kind of a pinch on the other side. That looks like that. So now we have this, and we're gonna need to make this fit on the inside of our art purse, and so we're gonna leave open the possibility of making these sides smaller later on and reshaping a little bit through these two areas. And this just looks like this. This bag will square off about like this, and it's, or even a little more, and it's going to have the boxed corners. And then this bag, I think this black one's going to be my stencil, and the other one's going to be my watercolor, color wash. So this one will square off somewhere around here. We'll have to match that up the best we can, and it'll have boxed corners as well. But so there we have it. These are my 6 boxes of fabrics cut for watercolor quilting. I haven't had them out, and it's been several years at least. But when I was doing this, I enjoyed it quite a bit. And in the town that I live in, if you go to the pizza place down the street and say, I need 6 or 8 pizza boxes, they'll just hand them to you. I'm sure you could get them somewhere for a small fee. My boxes aren't sorted perfectly, but they're adequate so that when I'm working on something, I can find what I need. It was fun getting these out. They're fabrics I haven't seen in a long time that I forgot I ever used.